Hey everyone, we're here on Calypso, and I thought that we would knock out some of these snark snots, which seems like a really weird name. But they're a slow-moving creature. We are kind of south of Fort Argus here. And so it kind of goes barycycles, not barycycles, snavel snots, and then these snark snots, and then on the other side. And just a few hundred meters, it starts turning into MERPs, which have a high aggro. So I thought we would set up over here and just kind of knock out some of these. Oh, wrong weapon. They got a few more hit points than that. But they're pretty slow moving. You know what? Think we will just use this. And we'll hit a few barycycles in here. Or not barycycles. I don't know why I keep calling them that. The snavel snots. There's going to be a handful here intermixed in. And we'll just kind of pick those up with the Barbarella, I think. Oh, that Dominant was actually had enough hit points. I could have used the other gun, I think. All right, let's get our reward. Oh, we're gonna go with Dex, I think. Although athletics is tempting. But these are pretty good maturity. It said old alpha when I looked them up. The good news is these snavels don't have good aggro range. And so, as long as I'm not trying to use F to target the next closest, I wouldn't even actually shoot them, I don't think. But we don't have very much of their codex done either. And so, if we kill a few and push that up a little bit, I'm not going to cry about it too much or at all. And so, because we're so low on this codex, we should be able to push it up pretty quickly. I mean, on both counts, it should happen pretty quickly for whatever snavel snots we get. Well, that reward was really low on those. Oh yeah, see now we're into the where the merps are. I was trying to avoid the merps. Yeah, this is a lot of quick codex. This is going to be awesome. We'll get a stat boost. Haven't even really looked at what we get this next round. Oh, well, I see stamina's on the list, and so we get some more stamina. All right, let's get that stamina I was talking about. So anytime stamina is an option, I take it. I don't know of any activity you can do to build up stamina like that. And all the other stats have an activity, shooting for agility, crafting stuff for intelligence. I don't there's but I have not heard of a single activity that's like, well, if you do this, you'll get a stat boost to stamina. We'll take a little bit more dex. Not gonna hurt us. It looks like the Snavel Snots drop Nova fragments as well. That's some nice, easy codex. Yeah, we had to upgrade our weapon a little bit. And so we're using. I think that drops on Cyrene. I think I bought it out of the auction house, but I think it drops on Cyrene. Just because it says Ozpin. But because these guys are so slow, it really gives you an advantage. All right, another Codex rank. So these go up pretty quickly. Although the value does seem to be pretty low on the rewards, which would explain why they're going up so quickly. Right? It's all relative. Still getting about 1.5% on the codex per kill on these, which is pretty nice. I think it's like ends up being like 60 something kills, 67 maybe at 1.5%. Since these guys aren't even reaching us, we can up our game even a little bit more. With the tinfoil hat. Let's see what sort of skill boost we just got. Ooh, 27%, that's pretty nice. Every skill boost is a nice skill boost. Because more skills are always better. Well, the merp concentrations seems to be increasing over here, so we're gonna kind of circle around and head back more towards where the snavel snots are, I think. So our main codex goal is going to be these snark snots. There's a whole island full of merps. We can get those anytime we want. And so far, we haven't really got anything of note loot-wise. Yeah, go ahead and take that perception reward again. I'm really trying to push that up. We're really going to try and focus on our looter levels a little bit and try and get it up a little bit. Just because getting more returns is always going to be beneficial, right? And they're starting to lag behind my other skills as well as the other reason. So we're still getting over 1% per kill, it looks like. All right, and that put a big dent on the next rank of this Snark's Knot challenge. We got a few codexes, I think three, but I actually wasn't counting. I think this is where we're gonna wrap this particular hunt up. Push these couple up a little bit. The Snabel Snot was definitely secondary to the Snark's Knot, which is what we were trying to do. We're getting back into these merps, and so we'd have to circle back around and kind of go north again. And so I figure here's a good place to wrap up. I hope that everyone is having an amazing day. Stay epic.